And News 4's Mike McCormick continues our coverage live and local from the Cowpens National Battlefield. Mike, the park was able to reopen this morning.
Right, Michael, and the gate is locked up right now, but don't worry, that's only because the battlefield here, the visitor center and parking lot, usually close every night at 5 o'clock.
On October 1st, employees locked up and left. 16 days later, visitors returned because, like this park, the government shutdown is history.
When I come here every day, it's home.
Bob LeBron is a World War II veteran who volunteers here at the Cowpens National Battlefield. He used to live on part of the property but sold it to the government, so when the park closed,
I shouldn't have done that.
He felt like he'd been locked out of his own home.
It was the worst thing they could ever done. It hurt my feelings.
The shutdown was personal for Superintendent John Slaughter, too.
I came out each and every day and met with the visitors that were disappointed about not being able to visit the park, and it was tough. It was heart-wrenching.
He says the 15 employees will get back pay, but reopening was like a big bonus.
We're pretty excited about it.
The sign at the visitor center reads, "Welcome back to Cowpens."
Looking forward to seeing the battlefield and learning about the history.
Jim and Susan Camba are from Chicago.
We've had the trip planned for about 2 months, and we decided to take our chances.
They flew in this morning.
I'm feeling lucky. We should be going to a casino, I think.
Though the shutdown didn't trip up their trip, they can't ignore the fact that it did put a lot of plans in park.
I'm pretty disappointed in the government, you know, in our representatives, that they let it go this far.
And because of the shutdown, the Cowpens National Battlefield couldn't be part of the Upstate Revolutionary War weekend, but the superintendent here says the city of Gaffney stepped up and hosted the events that would have happened here. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, live tonight in Gaffney.
All right, Mike, thank you for that.